Matrix chain multiplication. This is one of the application of dynamic programming. Let us see the problem definition. The problem is that you have given a sequence of matrices, okay, several matrices. Then you have to find the most efficient way to multiply these matrices together. Okay, so you know the dynamic programming technique we are using to find the optimal solution. Okay, so suppose if you are given three matrices A1, A2, and A3, okay, and A1 has the order 10 by 100, okay, and A2 has the order 100 by 5, and A3 has the order 5 by 50. Okay, now we have to multiply these three matrices together. Okay. So there are two possibilities in multiply these three matrices. That is, first you can multiply A1, A2, then you multiply the resulting matrix with A3, or you can multiply A2 with A3, then the result multiply the resulting matrix with A1. Okay, there are two possibilities because matrix multiplication is associative. Okay, but you cannot multiply A1 with A3 and then with A2. It is not possible, okay. But in this order, you can change either, that is, either you can multiply A1 with A2, then with A3, or you can multiply A1 with the result of A2 into A3, okay. So, now which order you prefer, which order you will choose? That is, there are two possibilities for you now for the matrix multiplication of these two matrices, sorry, these three matrices, okay. Now, which possibility you will use, okay. So you have to find the optimal solution or optimal possibility or the most efficient possibility you have to find out. Okay. So how we will say which one is the most efficient? We will say it in terms of number of multiplications we are needed for the computation. Okay, that is number of scalar multiplications that you need to multiply these two matrices. Okay, so suppose if you are having a 2 by 2 matrix, okay, say 1, 2, 3, 1, and let us multiply it with another 2 by 2 matrix, 1, 1, 2, 2, okay. So how many scalar multiplications needed to multiply these two matrices? Suppose to find the first element, C11, we have to compute, C11 will be computed as 1 into 1, plus 2 into 2, okay. So we need a 2 scalar multiplication to find out C11. So to find out all the elements, that is to do the computation, we need 8 scalar multiplications, okay. That is, in order to multiply 2 by 2 matrix, the rows and columns must be same, okay. The column number of columns of the first matrix, the number of rows of the second matrix might be same. So we need a total 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 8 scalar multiplications we needed. Okay. So now let us see if we compute the multiplication of A1, A2 and A3 in this fashion, how many scalar multiplication will be needed. Okay. So A1 is a 10 by 100 matrix and A2 is a 100 by 5 matrix, so we can multiply it. Okay, so in order to multiply A1, A2, we will be needed 10 into 100 into 5, like this. Okay, this 100 is common here, so we will multiply only 100 once, okay, to 5. That is 5000 multiplication plus, this is the number of multiplication needed, 5000 is the number of multiplication needed to multiply A1 and A2. Okay, so if you multiply A1 and A2, the resulting matrix will be a 10 by 5 matrix. Okay, I hope all of you know the basic rules of matrix multiplication. Okay, now we have to multiply this 10 by 5 matrix with A3. A3 is a 5 by 50 matrix. It has 5 rows and 50 columns. Okay, so how many scalar multiplication needed for this matrix multiplication is? It will be 10 into 5 into 50, which is equal to 2500. Okay, so total we need 7500 scalar multiplications to perform matrix multiplication in this manner. Okay, now if you take this order, let us see how many scalar multiplications we needed. Okay, say A2 into A3. So A2 is a 100 by 5 matrix and A3 is a 5 by 50 matrix. So that A2 A3 operation will take 100 into 5 into 50, that is 25,000 multiplications we need just to perform A2 and A3. Okay, so the A2 A3 will be a 100 by 50 matrix. Okay, and A3 is a 10 by 100 matrix. Okay, that is A2 A3. The result of A2 A3 will be 100 by 50 matrix. Okay, so now to multiply a 10 by 100 with a 100 matrix with a 100 by 50 matrix, you need a 10 into 100 into 50, that is equal to 50,000 multiplications. Okay, so total, if you add these two, you need 75,000 multiplications. Okay, that is, if you are multiplying the matrix like this, in this fashion or in this order, you need 75,000 scalar multiplication. But if you are multiplying these three matrices in this order, you need only 7,500 multiplications. So which one is the most efficient multiplication method? This one is the most efficient method. Okay? So the dynamic programming technique will help us to find out the most efficient way to multiply n matrices. Suppose if you are given n matrices, there are 2n cn by n plus 1 possibilities are there to multiply n matrices. Okay, so that out of these possibilities, the dynamic programming algorithm will help us to find out the best choice. Okay, the best choice means the choice with the minimum scalar multiplications. Okay, in the next session, we will observe the dynamic programming strategy.